it is time to start building, and I want to make a nice little village for these local hobgoblins. The first thing I want to make is a bakery. We've only been eating bread since we started this world, so it seems fitting that we'd have a baker and a bakery and that kind of thing as our first build and have it right in front of the gate. I've got a good design for a bakery, but there's a problem in that all the materials that we need are a little ways away. I believe there's some quicksand over here, and yes, I did say quicksand, that's what I meant. And there's some redwood trees up here. There's also some ash stone, which we're gonna need from a volcano either here, or I guess we could go over there because we need to go over here for some jungle leaves. I need them for some foliage. I should probably just use rubber. I like rubber, but I think the trip for the jungle will actually be worth it. So we got a long ways to go. Thank God they invented the montage. Quicksand may seem like an odd choice for a building material because of the whole suffocate you thing, but once you microblock it, it no longer has that property and it just becomes a block with a texture similar to like sand or the default clay, but a nice warmer color that I think will really serve us well in this build. We also need some microblocked grass, but we don't have a silk touch yet. So we're gonna grab these seeds and some dirt and make some topiary grass, which just has the grass texture on all the sides. And then we're gonna microblock that. And then from the surface, it's indistinguishable from regular grass. So to make it, it's just dirt in the middle and then seeds on all four sides for topiary grass. All right, let's get organized and start building. Okay, so it's supposed to be 10 away from the wall and then 4 in from the path right there. Okay, so we got a 3x6 here and then another 3x4 on the side. So as you can see, this is a really small house. There's not a whole lot of interior space, and that's by design. We're making these houses for tiny little hobgoblins. And the castle is actually relatively small for a castle. So for the scale to work out overall, we actually need to microblock these. And where's my saw? Crap. All right, so for the scale to work out, we actually kind of need fairly small houses, which works out because they're supposed to be for half-sized people anyway. As far as the interiors go, I'm not even really gonna mess with them. They need to function as doors for the village, and they need to be a place where the hobgoblins can go in and out. Aside from that, most of the buildings aren't gonna have anything in them because no one's gonna see them. I'm not gonna go in them, so you guys aren't gonna see them either. So we're gonna kinda use microblocks to widen the inside so hobgoblins can cram in there if they so choose, but otherwise the interiors are going to be completely bland because the whole function of this village is to house hobgoblins and look fantastic from the outside, and that's what we're going to do. Another thing I want to do in the village is actually make most of the doors recessed into the ground. And this will make all the doors look smaller and actually make the houses look bigger than they actually are. And this will give a weird effect, like they're normal sized houses for small people rather than small houses that just happen to have small people in them. That's a really weird distinction to make, I know, but I think it'll make a lot more sense as the village starts coming together. So the way this works is you put a cover on the back side of the block, but still in the block, of course, and then you design out the front side of the block with what you want, with like the posts and the nooks and the strips and stuff like that. And then you can go back and add in more covers to come all the way up to just the edge of the block. So you have this like cool two-layer thing, and then when you combine it with strips and stuff on the next block in, you have this really cool three layers that are really, really close together and look amazing. So a good way to make microblock bushes is to make notches and then kind of go over the area that you want with notches and make the general shape. And then you go in with nooks and you expand the notches to add some flavor and detail and all that fun stuff. And it's really, really effective. So that is the bakery, and the hobgoblins are already starting to move in, which is pretty cool. If you're liking this little 5 to 10 minute episodes for a build, let me know. I can do more as we add to the village. If you don't like them, let me know that too, and we can plan accordingly. If you like what I'm doing, please like, please subscribe, comment, tell your friends, all that fun stuff. Every time you do that, it adds fuel to the fire and keeps this train running. I'm enjoying the ride. I hope you guys are too. Thanks again for your support, and until next time.